Welcome to this Hasura Getting Started video, and today let's talk about permissions. So underneath everything that Hasura does is a data access story. This allows you to define how you are going to connect to your data sources, how we're going to resolve against those data sources, and ultimately how do we connect across different data sources. But a big part of that story is about permissions, because you simply can't just give everybody access to everything and hope for the best. What Hasura is going to allow us to do is, through its engine-driven approach, it allows us to embrace a predicate pushdown model where in our metadata, we define permission controls for those different data sources. Let's compare these two models, predicate pushdown versus Challenger A. Through Challenger A's approach, what you often have is a fetching of all the data from the system, and then in a gateway, you're going to filter out the data that the user doesn't have access to. While this works under the hood, it does require a very robust engine or gateway, and it actually runs a lot of data costs because you're overfetching all the data you need. GraphQL then becomes some kind of a fancy filter and not actually doing performant requests against your database. With a predicate pushdown model, we take permissions defined in the metadata, and when we generate our requests to the data source, we're able to intelligently only request from the underlying data source what we need. This allows for extremely performant requests. When you look at the chart here, you're going to see that as soon as you add any complexity to your GraphQL, and GraphQL queries can quickly become complex, this allows you to have extremely performant requests. Okay, let's visualize that. I have user A here who's trying to access their orders. Through Challenger A approach, when they request their orders, they get all the orders, and then they filter that out in the gateway and return just the orders that the users requested. It works. Through Hasura's approach, when the query comes in, we look at what does that user have access to, we generate an intelligent SQL query, and we fire that against the database and only return the results that they have access to. This provides a much more secure and performant approach. Okay, that's going to handle it for permissions. If you want to read more about how you work with permissions in Hasura, find that in the documentation below, and we'll see you in the next video.